So, this paragraph is about description. So, the main lesson of today is about a descriptive paragraph. Are you ready? So, let's get started. Now, let's start with an example. Here we have a picture. Have a look at the picture. What do you see? We have a girl who is taking some pictures. So, she is a photographer. Right, she is a photographer. Now let's read a paragraph about Amina. Her name is Amina. So let's read the title, starting with the title, My Best Friend Amina. Okay, my best friend Amina is an amazing photographer. She is 19. She is 2 years older than me. She's got short, straight, black hair and lovely brown eyes. She is slim, medium height, and very fit because she practices mountain climbing. She likes to wear casual clothes. Moreover, she is very talented, adventurous, and courageous. Amina always makes us amazed with her photos of natural landscapes that she visits during her free time. She has won a lot of prizes in some national photography contests. Her dream is to become a successful photographer at the international level. So this is an example of a paragraph about Amina. So she is a photographer. There are some description of her physical appearance. Also, there is a description of her personality and of her talents. Now, before we get started, let's answer this question. About Amina, of course. What sport does Amina practice? So here is the text. You can scan the text very quickly, go over the text quickly and find out what sport does Amina practice. Okay. All right. Yeah, very good. She practices mountain climbing. So she likes to go to nature to climb mountains, and then she takes some photos of some landscapes. So the sport that she practices is mountain climbing. Now let's analyze the paragraph and try to fill in this diagram. So we're going to focus on her appearance. That is, what does she look like? Now, we're going to describe her appearance. Then we're going to see what is she like? That is, how is her personality? Then we're going to speak about the clothes that she prefers to wear and also some of her talents. Okay, you can take notes. You can take a pen and a notebook and let's fill in the information. Okay, now we can go to the text if it's possible. So here is the text. My best friend Amina is an amazing photographer. She is 19. She is 2 years older than me. Okay, she's got short straight hair and lovely brown eyes. She is slim, medium height, and very fit. So these are some description of her appearance. Then, moreover, she is very talented, adventurous, and courageous. Here we're talking about her personality. Amina always makes us amazed with her photos of natural landscape that she visits during her free time. Okay, these are some description of what she did concerning her talents of photography. Now, let's move. Let's go back to the diagram. Okay, here. So, concerning the appearance, look at the picture. So she's got She's got short, straight black hair and lovely brown eyes. She is slim. She's not fat. All right. Medium height. So she's not very tall. She's not very short and very fit because she practices sport, that normal. Now let's move to clothes. She likes severe, casual clothes, everyday clothes, right? Now, what about her personality? She is very talented, adventurous, and courageous, right? So these are the main points of description that that were mentioned in the paragraph, right? Now, let's move on. Now, think of a gifted person you know. It could be a friend, a classmate, a relative, a neighbor, etc. And complete the following diagram about him or her. Same way as we did with Amina. All right? So you can choose a name. And we are going to complete the diagram with some description of the appearance. What does he or she look like? Then you're going to move to describe your friends or your relative, your neighbor's personality. What is he like? What is she like? What is special about him? Then you're going to speak about his talents. Okay? That is his qualifications. What is special about him or about her? What are his or her gifts or talents? So young people are characterized by gifts, skills, and talents. So what are they? Then finally, you're going to speak about clothes. What clothes does she or he prefer? Right, you can take some notes using your notebooks and pen. So as to think about these points of description. Again, I repeat, you have to focus on appearance, then personality, after that, talents, then clothes. So we can use the following table so as to enrich our linguistic repertoire with some useful adjectives. All right? Here, for physical traits, for appearance, we can speak about height, build, age, face, eyes, hair, and clothes. Now, for height, you can speak about tall, she is tall, he is tall, short, medium. Okay, now concerning build, we can speak about slim, thin, fat, etc. Well built. Now concerning the age, we can speak about if he is young or if she is teenager, middle-aged, elderly, that is very old. Now concerning face, now here we are speaking about round face, oval face, now wrinkled, suntanned, fair skin. Now concerning eyes, there are some adjectives we can use. Big eyes, round eyes, blue eyes, etc. Brown eyes, like in the text of Amina. Hair. Now we can speak about bald, straight, curly, spiky, etc. Concerning clothes, there are different kinds of clothes. Now we're speaking about casual clothes, everyday clothes. Shabby, smart, tidy, messy, so it depends on the appearance of your of the person you are going to describe in your paragraph. Now, concerning abilities and attitudes, now we can speak about intellectual abilities like intelligent, bright, clever, smart, etc. Now, you can speak about attitudes towards life, like optimistic or pessimistic, that is negative, extroverted, introverted, relaxed, sense, okay, sensitive, practical, etc. Now, you can speak also in your paragraph about attitudes toward other people. For example, sociable, quarrelsome, argumentative, easygoing, hardworking, trustworthy, reliable, etc. You can take some notes or you can make your own research in the internet concerning adjectives related to appearance and adjectives related to personality, abilities, attitudes, etc. Now, let's speak about the outline. Talking about the outline of a paragraph, now, a paragraph consists of three main parts. Now, the first part is topic sentence, TS. It states the main idea of the paragraph. So, usually, in English, a topic sentence is the sentence that begins the paragraph. It's in the first position. It starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. So this topic sentence or TS presents or introduces the paragraph. It gives the general idea of the paragraph. Then we have supporting sentences. At least you must write three supporting sentences or ideas. So support, what's the rule of supporting sentences? They develop the topic sentence. They give us more information, more details, facts, examples that develop the topic sentence, that elaborate the topic sentence, right? Then we have a concluding sentence. A concluding sentence, it's the last sentence in the paragraph. So be careful not to skip the line. So you continue in the same paragraph. So I recapitulate. So a paragraph consists of three main parts: topic sentence, TS, supporting sentences, SS, double S, concluding sentence. You can, for example, write linking words to link sentences of your paragraph. Now, this is the paragraph that we studied in the beginning of this session. So, let's read the first sentence. My best friend Amina is an amazing photographer. So, this first sentence is what we call topic sentence. Topic sentence, TS. So, here we it gives us some information about the name of the person we are going to speak about. It is Amina. She is a friend. She is not a relative or a neighbor. Okay. And we have some information about her talent. So she is an amazing photographer. Now, after the topic sentence, the TS, in the same line, we have full stop. After full stop, we have capital letter. S, she is 19. Her age, she is 2 years older than me. This is an additional information. She's got short, straight, black hair and lovely brown eyes. This is description of appearance. She is slim, medium height, and very fit because she practices mountain climbing. This is additional information, more details about description of her appearance. She likes to wear casual clothes. She likes to wear casual clothes. Talking about her favorite clothes, her style in clothing. Moreover, linking word, that's a linking word. Moreover, she is very talented, adventurous, and courageous. These are adjectives that modify the personality of Amina. Amina always makes us amazed. Amina always makes us amazed with her photos of natural landscape that she visits during her free time. She has won large prizes in some national photography contests. Here we have some information about her talents. So she participates in some competitions or contests concerning photography, right? So what do we call these sentences? These sentences that provide details, examples, additional information? Right, they are supporting sentences. Details, supporting sentences. Excellent. Finally, let's read the final sentence, or the last sentence. Her dream is to become a successful photographer at the international level. So that's the last sentence. It is the concluding sentence. Right, it's the concluding sentence. Again, it's a paraphrase of the first sentence. Here we're talking about photographer. We're talking about photographer. So this is guarantees cohesion in the paragraph. So remember to begin your paragraph with an indentation or a space in the beginning of the paragraph, and you don't skip lines here, okay, until you finish. That's an example of a paragraph. Now we've talked about outline. Now let's write the now with the information in the diagrams above. Now, in the diagram that we studied here, you're going to write a descriptive paragraph about a person you have chosen. It could be a friend, it could be a relative, or a neighbor, or someone whom you admire. So, bearing in mind the outline of writing a paragraph, that is topic sentence, supporting sentences, and concluding sentence. Okay? Now let's write the first draft. You can take a pen, you can take a piece of paper or your notebook. Now we can begin can start with an indentation with a space. For example, this is just an example. You can write your own example too. Now let's read the first sentence, the topic sentence. Karim Alami is the most amazing person I have ever known. Okay, Karim Alami is the most amazing person I have ever known. Now, this is the topic sentence of a paragraph. You can continue with more information. So you can, first, you have to provide some description of the appearance of Karim Alami. Then you can talk about his preferences in terms of clothes. Then you can talk about his personality, and after that you talk about his talent. What is he good at? Okay, you can take your time to write a paragraph. Remember, when you finish writing, after writing your first draft, you can exchange your paragraph with one of your classmates and correct each other's mistakes based on a checklist. For example, have a look at the following checklist. You can follow this checklist. For example, is there a topic sentence? Yes, you can tick the topic or cross. Is there any detail 1, detail 2, detail 3? These are supporting sentences. Oh, is there a concluding sentence? Not a conclusion, a concluding sentence. During your editing stage, you can see whether your friend has respected the following points. Capitalization, that is, for example, after A starts with a capital letter. So we usually in English we begin with a capital letter. After full stop, when we write another sentence, we write capital letter. Punctuation, comma, full stop. Usually in English, a sentence finishes with a full stop, a dot. Word choice, was the word choice successful? Spelling, now, so as not to fall into spelling mistakes, You have to use your dictionaries, of course, to check the spelling of word. Do the sentences make sense? Okay, so you can follow this checklist, or you can ask your teacher to provide you with another checklist. Now, after editing your paragraph, you can write a second draft. It's the final draft. After, for example, based on the provided checklist, you can write your final draft and send it to your teacher for further feedback. Okay, here we have an example. Okay, you can read the example. Karim Alami is the most amazing person I have ever known. We met at school and we have become friends since then. He is tall and well built. He has curly hair. He always wears casual clothes. In terms of personality, he is very sociable and trustworthy, as he always keeps secrets. Everybody wants to keep company with him. He likes sports. He's very keen at playing basketball. His dream is to graduate from university and become a physical education teacher. In a word, I have never met anyone like Reem before. This is a sample. You can write your own paragraphs about your best friends, your relative, etc. And you can follow this pattern. So leave a space, write a topic sentence, write at least three or four supporting sentences. Then you finish your paragraph with a concluding sentence. Okay, so we reach the final